बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एयर फाउंडेशन स्कूल सिस्टम। दिस इज़ क्लास 10th फिजिक्स। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द नेसेसरी कंडीशन फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ साउंड एंड ऑल्सो लर्न अबाउट द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल नेचर ऑफ साउंड। इन आवर टूडेज लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट सम बेसिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ साउंड। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स वी डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन द साउंड्स ऑफ डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट्स। सो दीज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर द लाउडनेस ऑफ द साउंड, the pitch of the sound, the quality of the sound, and the last one is the intensity of the sound. First of all, we learn about the loudness of a sound. Loudness means the characteristics of a sound by which we can distinguish between loud and faint sound. It is the characteristics on the basis of which we can distinguish between two sounds on the basis of their loudness or faintness. For example, whenever we talk to a person, our voice is low and its loudness is small, or whenever we address a public, our voice is high and its loudness is also high. Loudness depends upon some factors. Now we discuss about these factors. So these factors are the amplitude of the body. The first factor on which the loudness depends upon is the amplitude of the vibrating body. The second one is the area of the vibrating body. And the third one is the distance from the vibrating body. So these are the three factors which affect the loudness of a sound. Let's see how these factors affect the loudness of a sound. The first factor is the amplitude of the vibrating body. Loudness is directly proportional to the amplitude of the vibrating body. It means that if the amplitude of the vibrating body is high, then loudness is also high, and the vice versa. Direct relation means that whenever we increase one quantity, the second quantity is also increases. So loudness is directly proportional to the amplitude of the vibrating body. In this example, I show you two waves. In this wave, you can see that the amplitude of this wave is small. So small amplitude means faint sound and low loudness. Similarly, in this example, you can see that amplitude is high. So high amplitude means loud sound and its loudness is also high. So amplitude is directly proportional to the loudness. It means that whenever we increases the amplitude of the vibrating body, its loudness is also increases. The second factor is the area of the vibrating body. Loudness is also directly proportional to the area of the vibrating body. If you increase the area of the vibrating body, then loudness is also increases. For example, whenever you knock on your table, a faint sound is produced as compared to whenever you knock on the door. Since the area of the door is high, so sound produced by the door is loud as compared to the sound produced by your table. So loudness is directly proportional to the area. Similarly, we can see that a drum with smaller area produces faint sound and its loudness is small due to smaller area. And similarly, a drum with large area produces a loud sound due to its larger area. So loudness is directly proportional to the area. The third factors which affect the loudness of a sound is the distance from the vibrating body. First two factors is directly proportional to the loudness, but the third factor is inversely proportional to the loudness. If we increases the distance from the vibrating body, then loudness decreases. Inversely proportional means when you increase one quantity, the second quantity decreases. So by increasing the distance from the vibrating body, loudness decreases, and by decreasing the distance from the vibrating body, loudness increases. So these are the three factors which affect the loudness of a body. Now let's move towards the second characteristics of sound. The second characteristics of sound is the pitch of the sound. Pitch of the sound is the characteristic of a sound by which we can distinguish between shrill and grave sound. Shrill sound means the sounds like women, and the grave sound means the sound of men's. So pitch is the characteristics of a sound by which we can distinguish between shrill and grave sound. पिच डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द वाइब्रेटिंग बॉडी एंड पिच इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द फ्रीक्वेंसी. इट मीन्स दैट वेन एवर यू इंक्रीजेज द फ्रीक्वेंसी द पिच ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेज. सो पिच इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द फ्रीक्वेंसी. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी दैट in these two examples, in these two waves, you can see that here the number of waves are more. So this wave has greater frequency. So it means that this sound wave has high pitch and it is a wave of a shrill sound. Similarly, in this example, you can see that the number of waves are less. So it has low frequency, means low pitch, and it is a grave sound. So loud pitch is directly proportional to the frequency, and higher pitch means higher frequency, and it is a shrill sound. And low pitch means low frequency, and it is a grave sound. The third characteristic of a sound is the quality of the sound. Quality of the sound is an important characteristic of a sound, due to which we can distinguish between two sounds of same frequency and same loudness. If we have two sounds of same frequency and same loudness, then we can distinguish between these two sounds on the basis of their quality. For example, we can distinguish between notes of piano and a flute player of same loudness. Similarly, we can distinguish between sound of a drum and the sound of a flute. So correct quality is the characteristics of a sound, due to which we can distinguish between two sounds of same loudness and same pitch or same frequency. So the fourth characteristics of the sound is the intensity of the sound. Intensity means that sound energy passing per second through a unit area held perpendicular to the direction of propagation of sound. So intensity is defined as, intensity is actually the sound energy passing per seconds. From where it is passing through a unit area held perpendicular to the direction of propagation of sound. So this is the fourth characteristics of a sound, and its unit is watt per meter square. So these are the four basic characteristics of a sound, on the basis of which we can distinguish different sounds of in objects. So this is our today's lecture. If you have any problem regarding the lecture, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you so much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.